We just pulled in, beautiful view of San Francisco. And after a full year, maybe more, of planning, we are officially embarking on our Echoes 2009 expedition.
I'm thinking about other things I heard about today, all this week and tomorrow, and how these hands could create some better things for bettering. But you see, for now I got my own things. I can't help it, I got too many issues.
It was funny when we pulled up, all five cars are up there and there's a bunch of people. Like, I don't know, 30 people, and then you look back, and that whole wall of people, they're just gone. Because we just showed up, and there's billions of us, and we look like we're moving in. One lady's like, you guys camping?
Feel the weight of the world singing sorrow. Until you wish it just not.
As we pulled up to YWAM, there was like a bunch of people standing outside. Some homeless.
It was an opportunity just to be able to, I think, get to know the people here and be able to make relationships and just love on them, and that's my deal, I guess. And so I was really excited to be able to come up here and do that with the church.
We're gonna just be going through the city, helping out in the different, what's it called, social justice programs that they have in the city of San Francisco, so leading the group through that. Tonight we're making dinner, it's the first night here.
My first reaction was very good, and I just wanted to get out of the car. I was like shaking, like, let's go. So, but we had a really good first half hour here, so I'm excited.
And cut.
Over here, it's the Golden Gate Bridge. Now we made it here finally. And we bring a lot of junk with us. And we've been talking about that in college group for quite some time. You've got to leave something behind on this side of the bridge to get to that side of the bridge and give that city your best. To find a way to see Christ in the eyes of the homeless man that today you are scared of. We're going to use our actions this time around. Figure out what you're going to leave behind, and then when you're ready, take the walk. We'll meet you there.
Behind are just my inhibitions, just be able to go out there and say what I want to say and say the right words to whoever I meet.
I left behind judgment and fear, specifically for me, because those are the two things that I think I take with me when I talk to people that I don't know or understand.
I was kind of apprehensive about everything, about our group, and I'm really looking forward to seeing the challenges ahead and to facing them as best as I can.
And that's what I'm really excited for, is going to serve God in San Francisco.
Hopefully I left everything on the other side of that bridge, so we'll see how it goes. I'm excited.
I'm not a
there's a dark cloud over this place. I think that the stuff that people in the Tenderloin deal with just looks different than the stuff that we deal with. We as human beings, we classify that stuff. And most people classify the stuff that's outside this building as some of the worst stuff. There's prostitution outside, there's people doing drugs right in front of you, there's so many different things going on out there. But we have a commonality, and that's God loves all of us just the same.
We took our dollars and we bought this bread right here. And we also bought this jug of water and some peaches.
And
peaches. Some nectarines. We gave one piece of bread away to a homeless man. We've eaten most of the nectarines. I gave away my dollar to John, right? Good old John. John claimed to be run over by a trolley, but we don't think he was.
Today my group went to Glide, and it's just across the street from YWAM. And one of the many things that they do is they serve breakfast, lunch, and dinner to anyone and everyone who walks in. And that's about 500 to 700 people each meal.
Went downstairs, cut watermelon, made turkey sandwiches, put bread together, packed everything up. Probably did maybe 500 sandwiches.
So the San Francisco AIDS Foundation is a project that's based here in San Francisco, but it also, through the hotline, affects all of California.
Right now we are actually putting labels on the needle receptacles for the homeless so they can turn in their used needles and get them. That way it actually keeps the dirty needles off the streets.
Again, it's somewhat of a controversial thing to be doing, to be passing out clean needles and drug paraphernalia to these addicts. But again, it allows you to think of what could be prevented.
What do you think you can do, and what do you want to do, and really working with people as individuals and relating to them. And I don't know, I think you can learn from that as a Christian, because it's just about loving someone enough to help them, like no matter what the situation is.
It says, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no command greater than these.
Today we are sorting through peaches, sorting through the good ones and the bad ones. They give us three criteria to do so. They can't be mushy, moldy, or overly soft, I guess, yeah. So it's kind of because a lot of them like this, I don't know if that's mold or not. And this one's cut, but it's not mushy. So it's kind of weird.
It's a good one. That one's juicy. You can see right there.
It's juicy.
Bad one right there.
We're not only serving homebound critically ill HIV/AIDS clients, but also able-bodied HIV/AIDS clients that can come in upstairs and get groceries, and we'll see that in a moment. Also breast cancer patients and senior citizens around the Bay Area and Alameda County. The majority of it comes from the food bank, the San Francisco Food Bank, at 18 cents a pound. They also give their produce to us for free. They give all their produce out for free. There's no economic barrier to anybody that receives our services, but we are in the Tenderloin, our building is, because most of our clients do live here.
Yes.
Yep, peeling potatoes. That's what we're doing today.
Love is not a place to come and go. Yep, these are men's jackets. They're all really nice jackets. Folding them up, or picking them up, putting on the hangers, zipping them up, making sure they look presentable for everybody.
We're hanging up sorted clothes for their guests to come and pick out and kind of shop.
Ephesians 2:10. For we are God's workmanship, created in Christ to do good works, which prepared in advance for us to do. Not everything will be awesome, but I think it'll be pretty good. As long as I just keep remembering to actually trust and believe in something. This is really the one thing that keeps me stapled to much of anything, and has always been good to me. And that's one of the few reasons I still believe in this.
Visited a mosque today for the first time in my life. In going there, they welcomed us as a group. They were extremely open. They fed us. They gave us presentations on all of why they believe the way they believe. They communicated with all of the students and all of us.
So the human touch, what's important is how you reflect yourself with others, how you deal with others, that's what's important.
Read and read and read, study and read. If you want to know, read and research.
Just a really open, amazing experience.
Problems can be really scary to face alone, and I think God gives us each other. If we can't come back here and be real with each other and confide in each other about our scary situations, then I don't see what the point is. And what's been really cool to see on this trip is that people are feeling comfortable to share.
This is it. This is our last night in San Francisco. And in a lot of ways, like tonight is the sort of the peak that we get over, because in many ways we're physically drained and we're spiritually drained and we're emotionally drained.
Are we willing to seek truth, whatever that is? I mean, are we really, really willing to ask the toughest questions in our lives and look at it and say, I don't have any other place to go but say, this seems to be the most truthful thing that I understand about God and about the people around me. And if that means that we get rid of some of the stuff that we've held on to so tight all of our lives, then we need to be okay with that.
We were so open with each other, and we bonded. And it was like such an experience to be able to talk about things that you normally would never say.
Take a piece and go up to someone in this room and say thanks. Go up to someone in this room and say, forgive me. Go up to someone in this room. If you haven't had a chance to show them love, give them a little bit.
Sitting in our room last night and the way that our group just spilled their guts, that hit me pretty hard, touched me in a way. And I talked about having faith in something and not knowing what that is, but I have faith in what happened last night.
This trip was the last chance that I was gonna give God. I told my group, is like God reached inside and fixed that Rubik's Cube inside of me that I call heart. And I just know that This was the beginning of something that God wants to do with me. So if you feel like you came to this trip and there was no reason at all, you have to let go. Realize that the trip isn't over.
We cannot go around the room having heard people's hearts and say, that's not real. Because whatever it is that you're dealing with, small or large, it's always real. And Martine was right, the trip doesn't end. The trip continues on and on because we continue to support one another and love one another. Because we have the greatest example of love we have ever seen right in this book.
And this time you guys are at the bridge, you walk back together as family. And this time around, you're not leaving something behind. You're taking something with you. Every single time you come back to this place, it'll be special in a different way.
And just the community you see on the streets, they all know each other's names, and I think that's something to take away that, I don't know, we might not necessarily have that because we get caught up in our day-to-day stuff, but just to take a week away and to be able to focus on the people in our lives that we see all the time and to really learn something about them, I think that was really awesome.
I mean, I expected to go and, like, you know, build a relationship with God. I expected to talk to people. I expected to make friends, but like I mean, the bond that I got with my group was like way, like 10 times more than I could have expected it. The whole experience was just amazing, and I think it opened so many doors, like for me and for everyone that went to go on more trips like this.
So I think I learned what it's like to be a part of a community of people that are much more selfless than you ever could imagine. Much more honest and open than you could imagine. Just being a part of a community that feels true and genuine and full of integrity. And I think I learned a lot of what a community is capable of.
It was just amazing. It was a great experience. I loved it.